Now we're gonna check out this old rifle today. This is a 30-30. It's a JC Higgins Sears Roebuck. From my research, this was actually basically a Marlin 336. But if you recall, back in the day, Sears actually used to sell guns, among many other things that they no longer sell. So I guess from what I could find, it was produced and stamped under this name, just so basically it was for, my understanding, exclusive sale through Sears. But it's basically a 336. It's just got a different name stamped on it. So this one is a 1964. I actually picked this up from a local guy on an arms list. Really, I got a steal on this. I only gave $400 for this. And that was also with two boxes of ammo, which right now is impossible to find. It's in really good shape. It's got a little bit of patina on it. Zero rust. The bluing on the barrel looks almost like a new gun. The action is super smooth. It's like real smooth. Even when you put, I had it fully loaded and I cycled around into it, and you can't even tell any difference between it being empty right now and you put a round in it. It feels exactly the same. That's how smooth it is. Stock's in pretty good shape. It's got a few itty bitty little nicks here and there, but no real damage at all or anything. I would say this gun's probably in a 95 percentile range, at least 90%. It's got a real good trigger on it. It's decently light, probably, and I am catching that with my finger a little. I'm not letting it just smack into that pin. There's no way it's more than 5 or 6 pounds. Nice crisp break, absolutely no play whatsoever. That's also what's nice about these older guns, is the triggers are usually better than the new ones are. And also the metal on them's a lot better. That's why they get nice patina to them instead of just rusting the pieces like the new guns do. Now, I also inspected the bore on this, and it looks like a brand new barrel on the inside. It's still shiny, like has no wear at all in the barrel. The story on this, the guy I bought it from, he said he bought it from the original owner's widow. The original owner bought it in 64 or whenever, when it was new, and pretty much kept it all up until a few years ago when he passed. And I guess his widow sold a few of his guns, and the guy I bought it from picked it up a few years ago from her and never fired it, and now we have it. So it's basically a completely unmolested 1964 30-30 from the original owner. Because it was in one other hands prior to us, but it wasn't even fired. So it's basically coming completely unmolested from the original owner. And he said that, the widow said that the guy took it on a few hunting trips and that was about it. And it certainly looks the part. Real good shape. It even came with this nice sling. The brass got a little bit of patina on it too. It kind of matches. I like it. So we're going to shoot a few rounds here today, probably just one box, because like I said, it's impossible to find most ammo right now, but that includes 30-30 for some reason, and if you can find it online, they want a minimum of $2 a shot for it, which is ridiculous considering it should only be $1 a shot, if that. So I refuse to pay those prices. Luckily I got this with two boxes, so we'll probably put a box through it today, check it out, and until I can find more ammo. We're going to put her up after that, but I'm trying like crazy to find some more ammo for this thing so we can shoot it some more. So you'll see it out again, but today we're just going to put a box through it and just get a feel for it. All right, so I got a box down there with a 10-inch shoot and see on it. So we're just going to hit that so we can see where it's hitting. I have no idea if this thing still needs zeroed or what. So I'm going to hit that box relatively close range. Actually, I think I'm going to bring it in a little closer. See if it's shooting right, high, low, anything like that before we start reaching out, try to hit some of these other targets. believe it's 6. Yep. 7's about that short, so it's a 6+1. And I'm just using 170 grain Winchester soft tips. Alright, so it looks pretty straight, just a little bit high there, which it should be because it's only about 15 yards, so, and it has an adjustable rear ramp, so I got it down on, it's not all the way down, but it's on one of the lower settings, so as we go further out I can raise it up too, so it looks about dead on, so go hit some steel with it now. Can you see? Because I know it's real bright right now. Ready? I got it. Forgot how much harder it was standing. And might drop that sight down a little bit. You can start. So I got it on the second one there, so it'll still go down. I aimed under that red one to hit it, so it might be shooting a little high. We'll just bring that down. Alright, I'll slow down things a little bit here. I'm gonna hit my torso out there. And the sun is. Where am I at here? Sun's really bright. 100 yards, there you go. I can barely see my screen. 100 yards out there in the center is an orange half or third scale silhouette. I'm gonna use the bag and try to hit that. That sun is really bright. It's the sights are glaring. It's so bright. It's like right in our face. All I'm gonna hit that pop bottle real quick, and I got the GoPro down there too. You ready? Well, that's going to wrap it up. I just wanted to show you guys this little treasure I found real quick. It's actually going to Preston. He was looking for a 30-30, and I found him this one. But we're definitely going to be having it on the channel here again soon, hopefully. Like I said, I'm looking for ammo now, and try to do some long-range videos later. Maybe do groups with it. And though a scope is not going to stay on there, we might try to mount one up there just to make a video of it and try some real long-range shooting. But we'll try to reach out 200 and beyond with iron sights anyways, just as soon as we can find ammo. Anyways, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one.